So I told her, you know what you could do with that college degree? Oh, hi. What's up, everybody? Welcome to this fun and exciting cheat day review. Well, you never know what just might pop up in the world of Pop-Tarts. But we have three new flavors to try out. So the first one up, brand new flavor, is the Boston Cream Donut Frosted Apple Fritter. The craziest one of them all is the Eggo Waffle flavor Pop-Tarts. So these are the three we're gonna try today, okay? Should be fun. Going alphabetically, I guess we'll go with the Frosted Apple Fritter first. Yeah, set that there. Open this up. Nice ASMR. ASMR time. Hi. ASMR. All right, so here are the Frosted Apple Fritter Pop-Tarts. Not much frosting on there, but maybe it doesn't need it. It's a toaster pastry with flaky crust with hints of fry oil flavor plus delicious apple-flavored filling with the perfect balance of flavors of apple and spice topped with white icing. All right, so here we go. We're gonna break this open here. Give you the fullest idea of what this looks like there. So here we go, Frosted Apple Fritter Pop-Tart. I'm just gonna break the crust off here. We don't need the crust. I know somebody out there is gonna be like, I like the crust, it's good. I like the crust. Okay, so it's got the tart of an apple, but it's not like sour apple or any kind of just regular apple flavor. It has like a lot of sweetness to it, just like you would imagine a glazed apple fritter would be. I think they hit the mark on that one. Actually very pleasant. The aftertaste, I'm getting like little jabs. It feels like I'm getting little pockets of flavor popping on my tongue after I've already eaten it, which is a good thing. It's kind of a weird sensation, actually. But the, what's it say, hints of fry oil flavor, it just more or less tastes like a sweet apple bakery item. That's all. Now, when I was picking these up from the store, the lady that was stocking these at Target was like, oh, yeah, the ones I've seen that are new Pop-Tarts that are really good are the apple fritters. So she really loved these more than any other. She tried the Eggo ones and she didn't really like those, so we'll see what we think. But for an official rating of the Frosted Apple Fritter Pop-Tarts, it's got a good flavor. I'll give it an 8 out of 10. It's actually pretty good. My mouth is like watering, actually wanting more. And I'm looking at the second one in this package and I'm just like, no. You got two more to eat here. Okay, next one up is, I'm really excited about this one. This is the Boston Cream Donut Pop-Tart. See how this goes. Kind of just slathered on there. It's not really getting much full coverage on these. The website for these bad boys say that it's a toaster pastry with flaky crust. Duh! With hints of fry oil flavor filled with sweet, fluffy, custard-like filling and topped with deep, chocolatey icing. Once again, we're getting the crust off here because nobody likes crust. Do you like the crust? Make sure to comment below. Alright, so here we go. This is the Frosted Boston Cream Donut. Nothing but the best. Very center with the filling. Yeah. First bite right off the bat, it's kind of underwhelming. Yeah, I don't know. This one was kind of a letdown. It doesn't have as much filling as you would expect. The chocolate is, it overtakes the flavor more than anything else. And I think that's the problem. You taste more chocolate than anything else. And you know, you're looking for that Boston cream. I am a fiend for the cream. And I'm just not getting it here. I was not satisfied with the cream ratio. When I eat this, does it taste like a Boston cream donut? Slightly. But it's a very, very cheap imitation. And well, obviously it's a Pop-Tart, but you know, you're trying to get a flavor that is very reminiscent, and this kind of loses the mark. It's like just a chocolate with a somewhat vanilla custard filling. The custard filling kind of tastes like a chemical taste more than like an authentic taste that you would expect. So I'm gonna have to give these Boston cream donut flavored Pop-Tarts a 4 out of 10. You know, they're sweet. They'll hit the spot when you really need it, but as a thing that you're just gonna be fiending and craving for, you're not gonna find it here. Sorry to say, really big letdown. All right, so now we're at the final one. It is the Pop-Tarts Eggo flavored. And this is, the exact flavor is the frosted maple flavor. I found these at a gas station because I couldn't find them in boxes at the time. So when I bought these, I was just like, well, I may never find them in boxes because I live in small town USA and all the stuff comes out on the East and West Coast, but here it takes forever. So I thought, like, okay, I might as well buy these while I see these at the gas station. But they wound up coming out in regular boxes here, but I just wasn't patient enough. All right, so it looks like here we've got a mayonnaise and mustard mixture on the top. Compared to the regular Pop-Tarts, yes, these are actually yellow all around. So, normal Pop-Tart, Eggo Pop-Tart. So they kind of went all out. They even colored the pastry itself. Let's see what the website says about this. Frosted maple flavor Eggo Pop-Tarts. Flaky, buttery crust paired with sweet, iconic maple-flavored filling with yellow icing. This toaster pastry combines all the best elements of Eggo and Pop-Tarts. Yeah, it just smells like maple syrup. You smell it everywhere. It's just emanating from you. You're just like, whoa. All right, so let's crack it open here and get a good gander on the inside. There you go. Now we're gonna peel the crust off of this one. We'll just go in as it is. My God, that is good. I can't believe I'm getting this hyped over a Pop-Tart. All right, one last piece here. Okay, calm down. All right, I'm trying to think, but I can't really contain myself. I can't because these are so good. All right, so the frosted maple flavor Eggo Pop-Tart. It took a second for me to thoroughly enjoy and realize what I was tasting on the first bite. You have to let it settle in on your first bite. Because at first, your taste buds are just attacked with a bunch of flavors that you weren't expecting. Well, maybe you were a little bit, but it's beyond what I was expecting at least. So I'm glad I didn't pull the crust off of here, because this was one of my favorite parts, believe it or not. They weren't lying when it said buttery crust, because you taste literal butter. I don't know if they infused butter into this or what, but just this by itself, the crust was good. And then you pair it with the maple filling. Now, this is where it gets attacked a little bit, because the filling was a little lackluster. It was much like how the Boston cream donut Pop-Tarts were, where it's there. But the flavor was there. It tasted like maple. It didn't really have like a chemical, like artificial taste. It was true to its flavor. And then on top of it all, it's caked up with a lot of frosting on here. All that at once hitting you. You gotta take it a little slow, and then it hits you and you realize, wow, this is amazing. Now for a Pop-Tart, this is really, really good. Is it perfect? No, I think it gets a point off because the filling just isn't enough for it to be a perfect thing, but this is almost close to perfect. So I'm going to have to give the Frosted Maple Flavor Eggo Pop-Tart a 9 out of 10. That's the final ruling. 9 out of 10. Definitely pick these up when you see these. I don't know. Chances are all of these flavors are going to be gone within a limited amount of time. They're brand new now, and you may have a chance to pick them up, but don't sleep on these. If I could pick any one of these three, do not sleep on the Eggo Pop-Tarts here. Well, that is it for this fun and exciting cheat day review as we took a look at the latest Pop-Tart flavors that are out right now, and they are the Eggo Waffle Pop-Tart, 9 out of 10. The Apple Fritter Pop-Tart, 8 out of 10. And the Boston Cream Donut gets a 4 out of 10. Sadly, sorry, that's just how it works here. That is it for this cheat day review. Thank you guys for watching. I am DJ Glowing Ice, wanting to tell you that it's okay to cheat every once in a while. See you next time. See you next time.